Hi there, it's Kim Denny with Intertwined Art, and today we are going to make the dishcloth of the month. This is the Rainbow and Shamrock dishcloth. It has 17 shamrocks around the edges and a little loop for hanging, so it's a nice holiday celebration, and you can use it as a trivet or a rug mug or a dishcloth. We're going to start off with this grass 24/7 Lion Brand cotton. We also have the Candy Sprinkles cotton. And we have a size H crochet hook, a size G crochet hook, our scissors, and our tapestry needle. So we're going to set these aside, and we are going to start off with the size H 5mm crochet hook and the Candy Sprinkles yarn. And we're going to start a magic circle. So wrap it around your fingers, pull through, and then pull a chain through. And now we're going to put 12 double crochets inside this magic circle. Keep your tail over to the side and hold on to it with your circle, and we're going to work right into the center. So 12 double crochets. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Now you take your tail end here and you just pull it, and that pulls the center tight, so it'll close up that hole in the center. And then we want to join to the first stitch by creating a slip stitch in it. If you can't find the first stitch, just count backwards. So go back 12, and then you find that's number 12, and that's where your slip stitch goes. And then we're going to pull this a little bit tighter so it really closes off the center, and then we'll weave in that end in just a little bit. And we're going to chain two now. Oops. Get back in there, chain two. And then we're going to place two double crochets in each stitch around, so it'll be a total of 24. So there was 1, 2, 3, and in the same one goes number 4. In the next stitch is 5. In the same stitch is 6. Next stitch is 7. Same 8. Next stitch is 9. In the same stitch will go number 10. 11. In the same stitch is 12. 13. And 14. In the next stitch is 15 and 16, 17 and 18 in the same one, 19 in the next, 20 in the same, 21, 22 in the same, 23 in the next, and end with 24. And then we're going to go ahead and join that with a slip stitch to the very first double crochet and chain two. And now we're going to be working in sets of three. So we're going to chain or double crochet two in the first one. 1, 2, and then number 3 goes in the next stitch. In the next stitch goes 4 and 5 in the same one. 6 goes in the next one. In the next stitch is 7 and 8. 9 will go in the next one. In the next stitch is 10 and 11, and 12 goes in the next one. I'm just adjusting something real quick. And then we go to 13 and 14. The next one gets stitch number 15. Two in the next one. Gotta fix the camera real quick. Two in the next one is 16 and 17. 18 goes in the next one. 19, and in the same one is 20. Next stitch, 21. Next stitch gets 22 and 23 in the same. 24 in the next. 25 and 26. 27 in the next, 28 and 29 in the next. In the next stitch, we'll do number 30. The next stitch gets 31 and 32, 33 in the next, 34 and 35 together. And then we finish up with number 36. Nice. So we'll go ahead and join with a slip stitch again in that first double crochet. So get in the top of that stitch, pull your yarn through, and we're gonna chain two here. And now we're gonna work in multiples of four. So we're gonna go two in the first, and then one, and then one, and then two in the next, and then one and one. So here's one and two. The next stitch is number three, and in the next one is four. In the next stitch is five and six. The next stitch is seven, and into the next stitch goes eight. In the next stitch goes nine and 10. And in the next is 11. In the next is 12. The next stitch gets both 13 and 14. In the next is 15. And in the next is 16. The next stitch gets 17. And 18. 19 goes into the next stitch, and 20 goes into the next stitch. Next, we're going to do 21 and 22 in the same. 23, and in the next is 24. In the next goes 25 and 26. In the next is 27. And then 28 goes into the next one. In the next stitch goes 29 and 30. 31 goes into the next stitch. 32 goes into the next stitch. The next one gets 33 and 34 in the same. 35 goes into the next. 36 goes into the next. 37 and 38 together. And then the next stitch is 39. In the next stitch is 40. In the next one goes 41. And 42 together. In the next stitch is 43. In the next is 44. And for our last set, we've got 45 and 46 together. And then the next one is 47. And the last is 48. Yay, we did another round. Okay, we're gonna go ahead and join with a slip stitch at the top again. We're gonna chain two, and this time we're working in multiples of five. So we're going to place two in the first stitch, one and two. The next stitch gets number three. The next one gets four. And the next one gets number five. In the next stitch, we're going to do both numbers six and seven in the same. The next one gets number eight. Next stitch, number nine. Next stitch, 10. The next one gets 11 and 12 together. Then the next stitch is 13. The next is 14. In the next stitch, 15. Now we're going to do 16 and 17 together. The next one gets 18. The next gets 19. And the next gets 20. Then we're going to do 21 and 22 in the same. The next stitch gets 23. The next gets 24. And the next gets 25. Whoops. We're going to do that again. There's number 25 again. Okay. Then in the next stitch, we're going to place numbers 26 and 27. Number 28 in the next. 29 in the following. And number 30 in the next stitch. Then 31. And 32 together. 33 in the next. 34 in the next. And 35 in the next. Now we do 36 and 37 in the same stitch. 38 in the next. Then 39. And then number 40. 41 and 42 go together. 43 goes in the next. Then 44. Then 45. 46 and 47 go together. 48 is in the next, 49 is in the next, and 50 is in the next. Then we do 51 and 52 together, then 53, then in the next stitch goes 54, and in the next one goes 55. And then we have 56. And 57 together. 58 goes in the next. 59. And then the last stitch is number 60. And once again, we're going to join this with a slip stitch right into the top of that first double crochet. And we're going to start our last round. And this is multiples of six. So we're going to do two in the first and then four singles. And then repeat that. So here we go. One and two in the same. Then the next stitch is three. In the next one goes four. Number five goes into the next. And then number six in the following. Number seven and eight go together. Nine. And next stitch is 10. In the next one is 11. And in the next one is 12. Then 13 and 14 go together. 15 goes into the next stitch. 16 in the next. 17 in the next. And 18 in the next. Then we'll do 19 and 20 together. 21, 22 in the next, 23, and then 24. Now 25 and 26 go together. 27's in the next. 28 is in the next. 29 is in the next. And 30 goes into the next stitch. Then 31 and 32 go together. 33 in the next. 34 in the next. Then 35. And then 36. Now we're going to place 37 and 38 together. 39 goes in the next stitch. 40 in the next. 41 in the next. And then 42 in the next. Then 43 and 44 go together. 45 in the next. 46 in the next. 47 in the next. And 48 in the next. Then 49 and 50 go together. 51 in the next. 52 in the next. Then 53. And then 54. 55 and 56 go together in the same one. Then in the next is 57. 58. 59 and 60. And 62 go in the next. Then 63 and 64 and 65 and then 66. And then 67 and 68 go together. 69 in the next. 70 in the next. And then 71. And finally 72. Now we're going to join this with a slip stitch. Our circle is complete, so this is a nice, easy pattern that you can use as the start of a lot of projects. But we're going to grab our scissors here and clip the yarn. And then just pull that right through your working loop to fasten it off. Pull it tight. And we are done with the base. So super easy time to stretch your hands. Make sure that we're not cramping up. Get ready to work. We're going to start on the shamrocks next using this grass color. So we're going to switch out our hook. This yarn is a little bit thinner. We're going to make these 17 shamrocks in the little hanging loop that goes around the edge. So we are going to start here, but we're going to switch out the hook. I like to use a smaller hook for this 24/7 brand yarn just because it's a little bit tighter and it gives a little bit better definition to our shamrocks. So to start this off, you're just going to join it into any stitch around the circle. So just place your hook in a stitch with the right side facing you, the right side of your circle facing you. So pull a loop through and then yarn over and pull through again, and that's your join. Just pull that tight and you're ready to go. So we're going to start off with a single crochet in that same stitch, and then we're going to chain five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now skip 3 stitches on your circle. So skip 3, and we're going to go into the fourth one and do a single crochet. Once again, chain 5, then skip 3 and single crochet. And we're going to do this all the way around. So chain 5 again, skip 3, and then place a single crochet into that fourth stitch. Chain 5 again, skip 3, and go into the next one with a single crochet. Chain 5, skip 3, single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5, skip 3, and single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5. Skip 3. Single crochet. Chain 5. Skip 3. Single crochet. Chain 5, skip 3, and single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5, skip 3, and single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5, skip 3, and single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5. Skip 3 and single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5 again. Skip 3 stitches and single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5. Skip 3. And single crochet. Chain 5. Skip 3 and single crochet. Chain 5. Skip 3 and single crochet into the fourth. Chain 5. Skip 3 and single crochet into the fourth. Now we're going to chain 5. Skip those last 3, and we're going to end up single crocheting into that same stitch that we did our first single crochet. So it'll just be another single crochet in that same stitch. And then we're going to slip stitch in the top of that first single crochet to join the round. Okay? So that is the completion of our first round with the grass color. Now we're going to start on the shamrocks. I'm going to adjust the lights a little bit because I see that I'm kind of in the dark here a little bit. And we're going to start off by chaining 3, 1, 2, 3, and then we're going to single crochet into this chain 5 space. So we have the chain 5 on top, and the space is what is underneath it. So we're going to count that, go right into there, pull through, and then pull through the loops to make a single crochet, and now chain 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now we're going to count back 4 stitches from the hook. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go into that stitch and pull through a slip stitch. Now you have this teeny tiny ring that has been created here, and that's what we're going to work our shamrock petals or leaves into. To create the leaf, chain 3. 1, 2, 3, and now we're going to do all this into the middle of the ring. So yarn over, put your hook in the middle of the ring and pull through, yarn over again and pull through 2. So now you have 2 loops left on your hook. Then yarn over, put it into the center of the ring and pull through, yarn over again and pull through 2 loops. So now you have 3 loops left on the hook. Then yarn over, put it through the center of the ring and pull through, yarn over again and pull through 2. So now you've got 4 loops left on the hook. And then you're going to yarn over and pull through all 4 of those loops, put your hook back through the center of the ring and pull through. And basically you're slip stitching here into the center of the ring. So we'll do that again. We're going to make 3 petals on each shamrock. So here we go. 1, 2, 3 chains. Yarn over, put it back into the middle of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. So you have 2 left on the hook. Yarn over, put it in the middle of the ring and pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Now you've got 3 left on the hook. Yarn over, put it in the middle of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. You've got 4 left on the hook. Yarn over, pull through all 4, and then go ahead and slip stitch right back into the middle of that ring. So put your hook in, pull through, and pull through your loop. Let's do the last petal on this one. Chain 3, yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it in the center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. So we have 3 on the hook again. Yarn over, put it through the ring, yarn over, pull through 2. We've got 4 left. Yarn over, pull through all 4, slip stitch to the middle of the ring. Okay, now we're going to slip stitch this back to our chain 5 space. So we're going to slip stitch it right on this chain 5 space, but wait, I have my thing backwards, my dish rag backwards. So you want to have the right side facing you. Make sure the right side is facing you. Sorry about that. And we're going to slip stitch here right to that chain 5 space that we were already working in. Slip stitch there. Then chain 3. And we're going to start to work on our second shamrock. Chain 3. Then you're going to single crochet in the next chain 5 space. So single crochet. Then chain 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then count back 4 stitches, 1, 2, 3, 4 from the hook. Slip stitch in there to create our ring. Chain 3. And now we're going to create the first leaf. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. So now you've got 4 loops on your hook. Yarn over, pull through all 4, and then slip stitch through the center of the ring. Second leaf, chain 3. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring and pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. So we've got those 4 loops on our hook. Yarn over, pull through all 4. Slip stitch to the center of the ring. Last petal on this one, chain 3. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring and pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Now we've got 4 on the loop, on the hook. Yarn over and pull through all 4. Slip stitch to the center of the ring. Now we're going to slip stitch again to that chain 5 space that we're working at. So just put your hook in, pull your yarn through, and pull it through your working loop. Now chain 3. And I'll show you a couple more here, and then you can either pause the video and keep working around till you have 17, or you can rewind the video because they're all going to be exactly the same. So we're going to work all the way around until we have 17 shamrocks. So we just did our chain 3, and now we're going to single crochet to the next chain 5 space. and then chain 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Count back 4 stitches from the hook and slip stitch. Chain 3 and create our first leaf. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. Oop, careful. We want to have 3 loops on our hook at this point. Sorry about that. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through. Yarn over, pull through 2. So now we have 4 loops on our hook. Yarn over, pull through all 4. Slip stitch to the center and start the next petal. So chain 3, yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2 loops. So you have 4 loops left on the hook. Yarn over, pull through all 4. Slip stitch through the center of the ring, chain 3. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, put it through the center of the ring and pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. You have 4 loops left on the hook. Yarn over, pull through all 4, slip stitch through the center, and then we're going to do a slip stitch back through the chain 5 space again. So you want to just go right in through the front here, put your hook right in, pull your yarn through, and through your working loop. So we're just going to continue working these shamrocks all the way around. Here's a chain 3 again. And then single crochet into the next chain 5 space, chain 8, four, five, six, seven, eight. Count back 4 chains from the hook, 1, 2, 3, 4. Slip stitch into there. You have your ring created, chain 3. Create your first petal by yarning over, go through the center of that ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. So you've got your 4 loops. Yarn over, pull through all 4, slip stitch to the middle of the ring. Chain 3. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, insert it through the center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. We've got our 4 loops, pull through all 4, slip stitch to the center of the ring. Last petal, chain 3. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring and pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. Yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through 2. We've got our 4 loops, pull 1 through all 4 loops, slip stitch to the center of that ring, slip stitch your shamrock back to your chain 5 space, and chain 3 to start the next one. And we're just going to keep working this all the way around. There is actually space to put 18 shamrocks, but I put 17 and then use the last space for a little hanging hook. So you can choose to do whichever you want. I just like the number 17 because, of course, for St. Patrick's Day. So here we've got 16 done. I'm going to show you the last one and then how to work the loop to finish this off. So there's 16 at this point. This is number 16. And then we did a chain 3. Then we did a single crochet into the next chain 5 space, chain 8. You're probably a pro at this by now. You've done 16 of them. Here's number 17 that we're working on. Count back 4 spaces, do a slip stitch, chain 3, create our first leaf, yarn over, put it through the center ring, pull through two, yarn over, center ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through two. We've got our four loops here. Yarn over, pull it through all four, put it through the center of the ring to slip stitch, and chain three to start the second petal. Yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, and yarn over to pull through all four, and then slip stitch to the center of the ring. Our very last petal here, we're chaining three, yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, center of the ring, pull through, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, put it through the center of the ring, yarn over, pull through two, yarn over, pull through all four loops, and then slip stitch to the center, slip stitch to the chain five space, just like we did on all the other ones. Go ahead and now chain three, one, two, three. Then we're gonna create, on this last space, I said we're not gonna do a shamrock, I'm gonna do a little hanging loop. So I have the 17 shamrocks in this last space here. And what we're gonna do is just make a single crochet in this single crochet that attached this first round to the circle. So go ahead and just put a single crochet in that stitch. Then chain eight, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. And then we're gonna single crochet to this first single crochet here. We're gonna go right in there. And we're actually going to slip stitch it. We're not going to single crochet. So a slip stitch in that last single crochet. Then cut off your yarn, pull it through, and there's your little hanging loop. So you'll just weave in the ends, and you have your nice shamrock dishcloth here. A lot of people are also using these as trivets, so you could put a hot dish on there on your table to keep your table safe. A lot of people are using them as big mug rugs, so you might have your mug here, and either a space for a little snack, or if you're a tea drinker, you know, you always need a space for your teaspoon or after stirring your coffee. So there you have it. So I hope you like this pattern. Be sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel and to our blog at intertwinedart.com. Bye-bye.